important contemporary Chinese American composer, Zhou Long. Before I get into his two piano trios, I would like to give a short introduction about the composer Zhou Long. Zhou Long was born into a musical family and began his piano lessons at the early age of 5. During the Chinese Cultural Revolution, he was sent to a rural state farm for 5 years, which provided him with invaluable resources, including regional elements and folk tunes for use in his future compositions. The variety of folk tunes stimulated his imagination, inspired him, and also influenced his future musical style. He resumed his musical training in 1973, studied composition, music theory, and conducting, as well as Chinese traditional music. In 1977, he enrolled the first composition class at the reopened Central Conservatory of Music in Beijing after Chinese Cultural Revolution. Following graduation in 1983, he was appointed composer in residence with the National Broadcasting Symphony Orchestra of China for 2 years. In 1985, Zhou Long traveled to the United States under a fellowship to attend Columbia University, where he studied with Professor Zhou Wenzhong, Mario Dandowski, and George Edwards. After receiving a Doctoral of Music Arts degree in 1993, he became the music director of the Association of Music from China for more than a decade. This association is a New York-based chamber music group founded in 1984 that performed mainly using traditional Chinese instruments in music styles ranging from tradition to modern. Zhou Long has won various prizes and awards. He is currently Distinguished Professor of Music at the University of Missouri, Kansas City Conservatory of Music and Dance. Zhou Long is internationally recognized for creating his own unique musical language, which brings together the musical elements of the East and the West. He is especially well known for transferring the sound and the techniques of ancient Chinese musical traditions through Western instruments. The following two piano trios, Secluded Orchid and Spirit of Chimes, are brilliant examples of this musical cross-cultural integration. The first piece, Secluded Orchid, was written for violin, cello, and piano in 1983. It is based on a famous ancient Guqin piece called Yolan. Zhou Long uses similar structure and melodies of Yolan in this piano trio, as well as various sound imitations of Guqin. Guqin is a 7-string zither, which emerged in Zhou Dynasty. In Chinese, the word Guqin is made of two separate words, Gu and Qin. Gu means ancient, Qin means musical instrument. Guqin is constructed with two wooden boards. The upper board is slightly rounded and serves as a fingerboard, and the silk strings hang over the surface without bridge supports. It also has 13 jade markers on the edge of the surface to indicate the harmonics and the stopped notes. The bottom board has 2 sound openings. Guqin has a range of about 4 octaves, and its open strings are tuned in the bass register. Its lowest pitch is about 2 octaves below the middle C, which is the same pitch as the lowest note on the cello. Guqin has a unique low and dark tone color. In order to match and imitate this dark sound, Zhou Long unconventionally assigned most of the melodic tunes cello rather than the violin. In addition, you will hear divergent acoustic effects created by violin, cello, and piano throughout the entire piece in order to imitate different Guqin sounds. In general, there are three basic sounds made by Guqin. The first sound is called fan yin, which translated to English means harmonics. In order to reproduce Guqin's fan yin, the composer uses violin harmonics floating on top of the cello's melodic line to create a sharp and harsh sound. The second sound is an yin, which translated to English means stop the sound or stop the strings. At the beginning of this piece, Xiaolin uses specific techniques that indicate the pianist needs to stop the vibration of the C string inside the piano by touching the strings with her fingers. This muted and drum-like sound precisely recreate Guqin's an yin. Based on imitating the same an yin sound, the composer explores new ways to vary the tone colors through different techniques. Here is another example. The technique requires the pianist to use one finger, right hand, to press down the pitch G on the fingerboard, on the keyboard, without making any sound, which the other finger, left hand, hits the keyboard on the G in a lower octave. This will result in continuous overtones of both pitches. Translated to English, means scattered sound. This sound is mainly produced by clogging the strings. In this trio, you will hear a lot of pizzicatos in the strings and a piano to create this clogging effect, which reproduces this sound. The composer also uses different types of pizzicatos to enrich the tone colors. There are four types of pizzicatos in this piece. The first type is called traditional pizzicato. The composer mostly uses it in the strings, which sounds very percussive. The second type is called pizzicato glissando. It is a technique that the left hand finger glides upward or downward along the fingerboard after plucking the strings. The third type is called fingernail pizzicato. The composer decides to use it only in the cello. It is a technique by plucking the strings only with fingernail in order to create more metallic and sharp sound quality. Compared to percussive pizzicatos in the strings, the pizzicato in the piano sounds more resonant. Sound imitations of Guqin, you also will hear beautiful pentatonic melodies which provide a strong flavor of Chinese folk tune. Various sound imitations and Chinese folk melodies recreate this beautiful Guqin piece, Xiaolin, and also present the original expressions and ancient musical elements through Western instruments and techniques. Here is a complete performance of sculpted orchid. Hope you will enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
form as spirit of chimes. This piece was originally written for the Peabody Trio in 1999. The Western instruments, violin, cello, and piano, are skillfully used to imitate the timbres of three ancient Chinese instruments, jiahu bone flute, chime stones, and bronze bells. The composer used Western techniques such as strings in extreme registers, bowed and plot harmonics, slides in the strings, and quarter tones in the harmonies, in order to recreate the distinct colors and overtones of these ancient instruments. This piece is in a straightforward three-part ABA structure. Section A opens with string harmonics to imitate the unique sound of the bone flute. The jiahu bone flute was traditionally made of crane's bones and discovered in Henan province of China around 8,000 years ago. The bone flute usually has seven evenly distributed sound holes of the same size, producing seven different pitches. Some flutes also have an additional small hole besides the last hole, which helps to create changeable sound that transfers the timbre of the flute. In section A, the composer frequently used glissandos between the harmonics on the cello and violin, which gives the effect of suspended tone quality, as well as imitating the bone whistles. It also creates a mysterious atmosphere. In addition, the composer chooses to use quarter tones in some of the glissando harmonic passage. A quarter tone is an interval equal to one half of a semitone, or a quarter of a whole tone. Because the interval is very narrow and even smaller than the semitone, it will simply sound a little out of tune. Which creates continuous slides in pitches. The glissando on the internal strings of the piano produces a more graceful and harp-like timbre. At the opening of this piece, the dissonant minor second chord in the piano evokes the overtone of chime stones. Chime stones were generally made of stone during the ancient period. Chinese artisans picked different sized stones with nice resonance. It makes sound by hitting and knocking the stones with mallets to produce different pitches. The sustained chords on the piano nicely present this sonorous sound of chime stones. After a lively pizzicato transition, a beautiful Chinese pentatonic melody is presented with all of the strings in unison. Section B starts with a set of staccato eighth note motif in an energetic and fast tempo. The staccato articulations and lively tempo immediately change the mood from relaxing section A to exciting section B. This motif reappears a few times in this section and develops multiple ways. Pay attention to this motif. You will discover how the composer varies each time with different pitches and rhythms. Here is the main motif in section B. section B. In the middle part of section B, interior playing on the piano re-emerges. The technique requires the pianist to place her palm on the strings inside the piano to create the effect of the vibrations and harmonies, which sounds like bronze bell. Bronze bell is a percussion instrument made of bronze and played by striking the rim of each bell with mallet. It requires a well-balanced strike in order to make a loud but very resonant sound. Extreme dynamic contrast is another important compositional technique, which is frequently used in section B and makes the section sound more dramatic and exciting. The return of section A opens with a brilliant cello cadenza. It is an unusual choice by the composer to insert a cadenza in traditional piano trio. However, Xiaolin prefers to show the great virtuosic and percussive sounds of the cello. Toward to the end of the piece, you will hear this beautiful harp-like glissando in the piano, blending into strings glissando harmonics, which peacefully and quietly end the entire piece. Here is the complete performance of Spirit of Chimes. Hope you will enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
more professional as a musician. And also thanks for creating so many performance opportunities, which is very important for us, and we learned so much from that experience. Second, I would like to thank to all my committee members. I don't know, I don't see anybody. But it's okay, I'll send a video to them. I would like to thank my committee member, Dr. Judy Rockmaker, Dr. Andrew Campbell, and Dr. Jonathan Swartz. Thanks for teaching and coaching during these years. I learned so much from each of you in different areas. And of course, I'm very honored to have you in my committee members. Next, I would thank to my wonderful colleagues and good friend, which there in the backstage. Thanks for their hard working and hours rehearsing with me. I really inspired, and thanks for their contributions and sharing the stage with me for this special recital. Next, I would like to thank my husband over there. Thanks for your support and encouragement and prepare delicious receptions for everyone. I really appreciate for everything you did for me. Last but not the least, I would like to thank my parents. Unfortunately, they can't be here. Sorry. Unfortunately, they can't be here sharing the wonderful experience with me. Sorry. It has been a long journey to me, studying so many years in United States. Finally, I'm very close to achieving my dream. Very close, but not yet. Thanks for their education, support, no matter financially and also spirit. I can't imagine with their support and encouragement, I can go through so far, and finally, I'm almost get my doctoral degree. So I want to say thank you, my mom and my dad. I love you all. 谢谢老爸老妈. I'll send the video to them. So I need to do some translation in Chinese to make sure they understand it. So thanks again for coming to my recital. I can't do this with all of your support. So please feel free to have some food afterwards. I'll see you out there. Thank you.